It is absolutely fantastic to have you here with us this morning for the launch of this year's UK Jewish Film Festival. I guess the first question, can you tell us a little bit about where the festival came from, the history and what it's all about?
Yes, the festival originated in Brighton, Brighton Jewish Film Festival, and after 3 or 4 years, we moved to become national. UK Jewish Film was born, and it's been an incredible ride over these last 17 years since we first started. And we're delighted to be here with what I think is our best ever festival this year. We're very keen this year to focus on comedy and new voices. Both themes are really important for a Jewish film festival. And UK Jewish Film really seeks to promote new young filmmakers, both with our Pairs Foundation at UK Jewish Film Short Film Fund, and also our work with emerging filmmakers. We have a whole day at Film Museum Covent Garden. And the films that we've selected and invited really represent this, with films such as Blumenthal and Afternoon Delight, and our wonderful galas, which again bring UK premieres to the screen, but also films that wouldn't otherwise be shown in the UK. And I think that's really important. It's what a festival can offer, and we, I think, are very good at that. I think what a festival can offer, and we at UK Jewish Film really have offered over the years, is a chance not only to support and promote new young filmmakers, but to bring their films, which are not, after all, going to have high budgets, big promotional spend or anything, but to choose the best of these films. And we do get 600 films a year sent to us. So to whittle that down to 80 films a year, which is what's in our programme this year, is quite a task. But we look for the most inspirational films from around the world. And this year, our films come from 21 different countries. Well, of course, as a festival director, I find them all inspirational, and that's how we got from the list of 600 down to 80. It's a very tough choice because we have brilliant films sent to us. I think our opening night film is absolutely fascinating, The Jewish Cardinal. We have small documentaries too, which are really unique. Besa the Promise is a Serbian film, for example. Let's Dance really highlights the way Israeli choreographers have brought dance to the center of what they do best in Israel. I think a lot of the films, particularly the documentaries, really focus on Jews in the arts. And that's something else we've really tried to highlight this year. It's really important to us that the programme is attractive to both Jews and non-Jews who come to the festival, and we've always had a real policy of being incredibly inclusive, both in the way that we programme films and also with our special events, and everything that we do focuses on this not being a film festival where you have to be Jewish. You don't have to be Jewish to come to UK Jewish Film Festival. So some of the films that we have brought this year have, for example, Palestinian and more Muslim focus, Inheritance, which is Hayam Abbas's first directorial film, is really strong, and we have other documentaries that I think will really attract. For example, The Last White Night is about the Ku Klux Klan. And there are many others in this genre. I think it's vital that we tackle the difficult issues. We can't be a film festival that just celebrates Jewish culture and Israeli life. A third of our films are Israeli, but we do bring some challenging films. Art and Violence is one of them, really, which doesn't shy away from looking at really difficult issues in the Middle East. I don't think we would have integrity if we didn't bring more challenging films, and also films that address wider issues which are relevant to Jewish cultures worldwide, but are equally relevant to many other different communities throughout the world. I think we're on the right track. We really listen to our audiences, and I think that's been part of our success. we modify the festival each year. And for example, we've just started a video on demand channel. And this really means that our films can reach people right across the UK. You don't have to live in London, Manchester, Leeds, Liverpool or Glasgow, where we show the festival, we take the festival. You can now see our wonderful films online. And I think this is really important.
If people want to get involved in this year's festival, want to watch the films either here in London or online, can you tell us a little bit about where they can go for more information about that?
Well, do go to our website, www.ukjewishfilm.org, and you can just type in UK Jewish Film Festival and you'll find our amazing website, which has trailers and really comprehensive synopses and details about all the films and events. And we open on the 30th of October and run right through until the 17th of November in 12 cinemas in London and the other cities that I've mentioned.